What happens in Vegas actually stays in Vegas. As we told you yesterday, those Vegas officials want these companies to do more to protect the privacy of Americans. And they have launched a campaign called Know the Code. Bob Massey is a Las Vegas attorney and longtime resident of Sin City and a good friend. Hey, it's great to see you, Bob, on this issue.
Good to see you. Thank you.
You know, this isn't the first time that the Las Vegas Convention Bureau has, you know, kind of grabbed the news and done an advertising marketing campaign with it. But this was a bit surprising. What do you think the motivation is here for Las Vegas officials to spend this much money on ads?
I think, like any major city, to be honest with you, I think it's great that they're basically standing up for the privacy of individuals. They're reminding these companies that people who travel, people go to Las Vegas and spend millions of dollars in a year, New York City, Chicago, L.A., that, in fact, they're stepping out and they're saying, wait a second, recognize our fundamental rights. Recognize that you and I as individuals have the right to privacy. And as a matter of fact, protect these people's rights to privacy. Because, look, if people come to Las Vegas and they're spending a lot of money and you have big gamblers, the last thing that casinos want, regardless where they are in the world, is to have that information available in some fashion through these organizations. And it seems to me that what I like about this the most is they sort of are speaking for all of us as individuals, as a city. And I commend that, and I think other cities you'll see step up to the plate on this issue.
Well, Bob, you know, one of the things that's different, I guess, about Las Vegas than other cities and privacy issues is the amount of big money gamblers that are coming in there. I mean, is that a real concern as far as you know, that they want privacy when they're spending this much money on gambling or privacy for other activities that they're doing in Las Vegas?
There's not a casino you can't walk in, as you know, that doesn't have eyes in the sky, video surveillance on the strip, permanent surveillance, as you know, on the strip now. That's for crime prevention and things like that. That's distinctively different. If, in fact, we go into a public place and we want to gamble and we're spending a lot of money, number one, there's a lot of people that watch you gamble. Number two, there's an expectation of no privacy in that situation. Not a problem. However, when you are taking personal data that we've seen in the last few months, and that personal data is being used for the government to basically do whatever they're saying they do, and I don't believe a word that they're saying. I think it's more pervasive than they're leading people to believe. That is distinctly different when it comes to the expectation of privacy. And if we keep eroding these type of rights, then you and I, as citizens of this country, basically will have no privacy whatsoever. Yeah. Our phone records and everything else that's proprietary to us now becomes public to the government, and they could use it any way they want. And that's what's offensive to me, and that's why I think any major city like Las Vegas or otherwise needs to stand up and has stood up for individual rights.
Millions of pieces of data around the world, and a lot of it in Vegas, sensitive data, to say the least. Bob Massey, Bob,
Very
thank
much.
You. Good to see you.
It's always a pleasure to be with you. Thank you for asking.